Everybody, thank you for coming here tonight. We know that there are also other events tonight, so thanks for being here with us, and we hope we won't disappoint you too much. So I'll ask Zuzana to start the introduction of our organization, which is called R, and later on I will follow.
Okay, so hi everybody, thank you for coming again from my side. And so we thought with Edith, because there's supposed to be a talk that is sort of showing or presenting the Czech art scene, and we should sort of be talking about the Czech art scene. And we thought, because we are running an organization that's called R, together with Edith and another curator that is not here at the moment, but it's kind of like a Prague and Brno based organization. We don't have a space, but we collaborate with a lot of non-profit organizations and institutions, also locally in the Czech Republic and also internationally. And we thought that maybe it wouldn't be a bad idea to sort of try to present the art scene through the program, through the programming that we are organizing in Prague. So we actually started the project, the art organization, in 2013, and it was like for both of us, it was like a side project, because we were also working or doing something else. And we thought that it would be a good idea to support the local art scene that we thought was very sort of closed and not internationally recognized. So we thought it wouldn't be a good idea to kind of like run a visiting program for international curators. So we invited several people from different countries, and since 2012 to nowadays, several curators who worked or who are working independently, as well as in an institution and institutions, and we sort of invited them to Prague and try to also present them the art scene. We made a lot of studio visits with Prague-based artists and show them institutions and collections, and so this is how we started. And then we were sort of like lacking, or then we thought that would be that's important to us to create sort of like a long-term relationships with the people that we are inviting to Prague. And the first an exhibition that we organized with Fionn Meat. He's an American curator that is currently working at the World Art Center, a very important museum in Minneapolis. So we organized kind of like
it was a big project, which was contained from like two big exhibitions in two different places, and also there was one sort of theater performance by Eva Kotiátková in Studio Hrdinu. Studio Hrdinu is a really interesting space in Prague, which is placed in the National Gallery, in the basement of the National Gallery in Prague, and they have really a nice program. They do really in a way experimental dramaturgy of a different like interesting place place or what do you call it place dramas. So and the space itself is really interesting, and so we decided to sort of produce with Eva Kotiátková a piece of her for that project. And also the one of the exhibitions took place in the Center for Contemporary Art in Futura, which is another space for contemporary art, which has been around from 90s, I don't remember exactly the year, but it's a really complicated space, but run recently by a really interesting curator, Czech curator. His name is Michal Novotný, and second part, the second exhibition took place, was supposed to take place in the commercial gallery in a way, like half commercial, half independent gallery suite. Also quite interesting, this quite interesting program, and Zuzana is one of the founder of the gallery and worked there for what, 3 years?
What we basically like try to do with this exhibition, because the curator was coming in the previous year for a visiting program, and then he met a lot of artists and sort of like was familiar with the art scene, and we sort of organized a big exhibition that, as Edith said, took place in three different spaces in Prague. And he actually invited a lot of international artists, but also included some of the local artists. So I'm just gonna show you the images of the show.
So this is the space Futura. This is work of Ben Schumacher, who is recently living in Berlin. Now he's in New York, okay, sorry. And the title of the show was Coming to Reality. So the concept of the show was the idea was to sort of express the situation of today, image and art, which are not sort of commentary to what's going on. They don't happen post, but they are actually like really the content of the reality. So they are the reality itself. So it's we don't anymore differ between the first and second nature as we used to before the let's say post media condition. But the image and art really happens to be already the reality.
I apologize, there's too many images all the time at the Contemporary Art Daily, so I hope it's not so that bothering.
So you can go just through it. So you see that the space differs very much like from like very underground to almost a white cube situation. This is work of David Markovic, who we all are familiar with. Maybe we can go through if possible. Yeah. This is work of Dominic Lang. When he sort of created this construction, and then the construction stayed there for the whole duration of the show, and it was taken off at the very end. Mm-hmm. So
after
the end, so it was in a way present but not visible. And this is work of Eva Kotiatkova, and she did a performance, as I said, in Studio Hadino prior to this exhibition. So she thought of a different format of this piece, and she made it in a, like a spatial distribution of the performance. This work of Jiří Kovanda, who was recently here in Sofia. Sofia and had a lecture at the Czech Center. Probably now this is a really nice piece when he asked a young photographer, a she photographer, to take her clothes off and take a picture of him from behind. So there was a question of the sort of he would make her in a way confidential, that he won't turn while she was naked and taking picture of him. And you can notice the situation only from the shadow, that there is a shadow of another person from, you know, you see, if you can see that. So I really like this piece.
So this is our work by Seth Price, American artist. So we are still showing images from the Futura Center for Contemporary Art. It's, as Edith said, it's a complex space of many rooms, and that's kind of like a very complex structure. So when you are in Prague, you should definitely visit.
Futura is always having like curatorial exhibitions. They also have a residency program, so it's a nice connection of the residency program and exhibitions right now, that it really works. Sometimes the residential spaces are not as you know, as connected with the exhibition program, but in this case it works quite well, because Michal Novotný has his conception of how to handle the program, the whole thing.
So this is a piece by Zbigniew Balaban. You can come to see at the ICA
gallery here in Sofia.
In Sofia, he has shown this piece as well. This is a work by James Mitchell. British artist. We are currently working on a screening program together with him and one other curator, British curator. So they are coming in a few days to Prague, and they will present a series of art movies in the French Institute.
They will also have a workshop at our school, the Academy for Art, Architecture and Design, where I also teach in the sculpture studio together with Dominic Lang. And we quite often cooperate together, like our organization and our school. So it really makes quite sense to have these interesting people to come to the school and talk to our students and have workshops together, or consultations, or whatever activities we come up with. Sorry.
And so this is an exhibition hall that is called Nová Scene, like New Hall. There is written Svit because Svit, the gallery Svit, rented the space for the other part of the exhibition curated by Fionn Mead. It's, I don't know how it is here with actually the space previously, or that time when we were organizing the exhibition, was organized or ran by Union of Artists. And this union was previously, when it was founded, I think it was like the beginning of, or maybe like end of the 19th century even.
Yeah, before it was a little different organization, but the Union of Czechoslovakian Artists was more like the communistic organization. And then they had a lot of like buildings and exhibition halls. I think the best ones in the city. As you can see, the gallery looks really, really nice, and there were like really good exhibitions happening in the 19th, right after the revolution, and then the women sort of took took over to this place, and as well as the gallery Manas, where there was which belonged to the previous union of artists, which was not the communist one, but before, and which really belonged to the artists, and they founded like not only artists but also architects, and so it belonged to them. And then after the revolution in the 1990s, what happened was that these places basically got in a way privatized. So the union still has the places. Some of them they already sold. They also have artworks. There was like quite some collection of artworks, but we don't really know what they've been doing because it's not really transparent. And there was also I don't know, maybe it was like 2 years ago. There was like in a way like movement when the artists decided to occupy the Manas. Not this place, but the other one, which belonged to the union. And we occupied the building for several days. We had some cultural events there, but it was in a way symbolical occupation because we knew that we cannot really do anything because it's legally, it's a lost case. But the art scene founded a new organization, which is called SPOLEK.
Association,
yeah. And they focus on like to not only get artists together, but also have some sort of like, you know, like even like a lawyer support, or have like let's say storage spaces, or find materials for artists. If they're used materials, then they gather it and then they distribute it to the artists. So it was quite there was something fruitful coming out of the occupation, and we also had the feeling that we have to say at least once again no to this situation. So this place, Nová Síň, still belongs to the union as well. They rent it out. You can rent a space for quite a big amount of money, and you can have a show there. But before, like in the 90s, it was a place where really like prestigious and good artists had their shows. So, and it's a beautiful space.
There's the space has even like a longer history. I think it was built in the 20s. Also very progressive period for the Czech art. And there were very important exhibitions in this space, like Picasso and Bach, and sort of like a progressive artists and movements were presented in these spaces. So we sort of, the program at the moment of this institution or organization is very bad, and they are sort of, they rented out the space for the auction as a, so it works as an auction house at the moment. But we thought for this exhibition, and we rented the space from them, and we thought it would be interesting, sort of like a
gesture maybe that to
demonstrate.
Yeah, because no one like from the from like our sort of a group of artists or would rent a space, you know, we would never enter the program. But we thought with this exhibition it's in a way appropriate that we can try to do that. But it was really interesting, even though we had really good PR and everything. In Futura there was more people for the opening, but this place just doesn't work for contemporary art anymore. But everybody was amazed how the space is beautiful, because people don't know the space anymore. Okay, so maybe we can go a little further. So you can see in the back there are Kovanda's pieces, his little boxes, and on the side there is Nina Bayer, recently living in Berlin, and previously from Oslo, no, no, Oslo, and in front you can see there you cannot see it very well, but it's a huge pedestal. There are pieces of Lukáš Jasanský and Martin Polák, and you had the chance to see their work in Plovdiv. I made an exhibition in Plovdiv of their work in the Rupert Gallery, and maybe you can call it.
So these pictures are the third part of the whole exhibition. That was the performance by Czech artist Eva Kotiatková. I was very much interested in a performance and theater. So just quickly go through the pictures. This performance was sort of like a reenactment of a performance that she produced for London Festival of Anxiety. Yeah, at the same year, I think. And there was a short video from the performance, so you can get there. Did you need to go there? So we didn't know how to operate the PC. Do you know what, if you have any questions, you can jump into our talk and ask, because it's not really a lecture.
Okay, you mentioned several times this union of artists.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Are they active somehow in Prague? Are they doing something?
You know, both places, they have pretty much the program auctions, you know, and here and there they make exhibitions for themselves, but you don't really.
How big is it?
The union?
Yeah.
I don't know how big is it.
I think
it's quite big, like
maybe hundreds of people,
maybe more. Because once we sort of speculated with Vita Vranek, we thought, okay, the only chance how to change the situation is that, like, the whole scene of the young artists will enter this union. And we tried to count it, and we realized that it's not enough of
it. It didn't
work. The thing is that these sort of the union sort of occupies the best, most beautiful spaces.
Mm-hmm.
In Prague, that could produce a great program. But the program that the union produces is it's very commercial setup. They just rent out the space to anybody who can pay the rent.
Yeah.
Then it's very hard. So it's very unfortunate. And there's a topic or issue that we are going to talk about. As well, because the institutions in Prague do not really work so well, and so we think you might be in probably a similar situation. So the non-profit organizations and associations that are in Prague sort of like replace the state institution in a way. So this is also what we thought that we are sort of like doing. As well, that we are sort of inviting international curators to present the art scene, because this should be a work of an institution and its curatorial team, and not a small non-profit organization as we are. So we think, of course, that we are sort of very influenced by the current situation, at the art scene, and of course the program that we are producing is very much reflects the current situation. So this is the very short extract from Eva Kochatkova's performance. I think it has 4 minutes.
Dobrá. Co tenhle? Ten na mě velmi zapůsobil, když jsem ho poprvé uviděla.
Tenhle dobrý.
To známe, ne?
Lidé spí ve stole.
To je poměrně nám vyzvá není už pravda. Jseš si jistý, že ti lidé spí?
Ano, ano, jsem si tím jistý. Jsem si tím naprosto jistý.
Proč by spal ve stole? Když mohou přece mnohem pohodlněji spát ve svých postelích.
Že se jim už nedaří poslední kusno. Já, že postele nejsou pohodlné. Nebo je chodí ošetřovat tak často v noci kontrolovat, že je vždycky probudí. Možná to připadá nepřirozené, spát v posteli. Že je s ostatními pacienty.
Aha. Cítíš se takhle ty, Antonína, ve své
posteli? Ne, já mluvím o ní. Mluvím o na obrázku.
Samozřejmě. O těch na obrázku, o čem taky jiném. To tenhle.
Zajímá.
Dobrá. Tak tenhle.
Tenhle je dobrý, líbí se mi. Ta větrek na bodu bude ptáka, který na ní sedí.
Není to náhodou naopak?
Ne, to zajisté ne. Vidíš to přeci, já jsem na obrázku. Ta větrek se chová úplně stejně jako ten pán. Kopíruje ho. Má stejnou pohodu.
Přece je hrozně nápadná. Možná má pravdu. Myslíš si, že na sebe věci takhle reagují? Že jedna věc může takhle pozměnit druhou?
Nikdy. Židle sedí stejně jako já. Jako závěr zase dělá, jako bych stál za ní. No, já tam vůbec nejsem.
Na obrázku to vypadá, že tak odpočívá, že to naše pohodlné místo.
Záleží na tom, jestli odpočívá dobrovolně. Co když se zvednu? Ale ta větev mu to brání.
Jak by mi to mohla bránit?
No. No to on tady. To je mu přivázaný. Když se pokouší zvednout, jíhá větev spáhne zpátky.
Zajímavé. Velice zajímavé. Zdá se mi, že máš tendenci vidět překážky a komplikace na nečekaných místech, možná i tam, kde nejsou nebo nemusí být. Co tenhle? No, samozřejmě, já jsem tě nechtěla vynechat. Já mám ten obrázek odstranit? Mám ho dát pryč? Řekni, co se děje?
Je to moc hlasité, moc hlasité.
Co je to za zvuk? Můžeš ho popsat?
Že opičí, že?
Dobře, dávám ho pryč. Že pryč je to lepší?
Did you want to watch it? To the end? Because it's just an extract of the performance, and if you would be interested, we can send you a link to the whole performance.
So here we also decided to sometimes like produce artworks. So that's something quite new for us, and we thought that because this is also very missing in our scene, that there are some institutions who, of course, if there's an exhibition, they give money for production art pieces, but not that they would really commission art piece, just. But that's also we decided to, that we did something that we tried to also find money for.
I just wanted to ask you, Masha Bernal, that you do something there too.
Yes, our colleague, he's from Brno, his name is Jan Zalesha, and he's also connected with the art school in Brno. He's the head of the faculty, yeah. And He's a really good curator and quite good thinker. So we cooperate with him as well. And the next program, which is coming up in 2016, is very much based around his exhibition and program around the exhibition, which is called Apocalypse Me. And it's happening actually in Ustin at Labem, which is another quite interesting city in Czech, with the university, which has also fine art department, where Jiko Vanda teaches at the studio performance studio.
So this was an example. Maria Mendes, she's Portuguese curator. She came for the visiting program to become familiar with the art scene. But we also tried to do like public events with the curators that are coming. And so this was her lecture at Transit Display on May this year.
So we started at school, in our studio, we started to cooperate with with Bill and Galia Collective, and they are based in London. And we were very much interested into the quite like contemporary way of like contemporary theories or philosophies of the object-oriented ontology, which was quite sort of in a way born in the Goldsmith and around. Around Goldsmith School, where Bill and Galia collective also studied their PhD, and so we decided to work with them in the studio, and we invited them to Prague, and also then they invited us to London, and then we invited their students to Prague, and so it was like ongoing program of exchange. And then we decided that we want to produce also a music program. In a way, it's music, but it's more of a like a performance, or it's like it's a, in a way also like a political statement. So this also happened in two places, in the studio Hedino, as I described the space for the experimental theater, and also in Ostrava. In Ostrava, there is a really interesting curator who was previously working at the Moravian Gallery in Brno, which is the second biggest institution mm-hmm. In Czech Republic. You know, quite well functioned, and he was the director, and then he decided to leave the institution because he was there for a long time. Was that?
Is it Joseph Danek?
It's Martin Marek Pokorny, and so he now founded an organization which is called Plato, and it's really interesting because he's got a really interesting program there. And so we decided to cooperate with him, and we cooperate quite often. And the concept was produced also there, so it was on two places. And it was three groups. It was the group V, Ravioli, Miave, and Galbert. And maybe we can play.
Let's go.
Thank you.
Sounds very little goblins out there.
No, it's catcall.
Oh, no.
No, it's goblin.
There it is. I told you.
Goblin baby has a goblin daddy. The goblin daddy has a goblin doggy. The goblin doggy has a goblin kitty. Goblin kitty has a goblin mummy. The goblin mummy has a goblin moggy. Goblin moggy has a goblin Tommy. And that's the story of the goblin city.
Which was before the Ravioli Me Away. It's really interesting because we don't really have a strong feministic positions in Czech art. We have really a big problem to, or at least the artists who were part of the scene in '90s or early 2000s, the female artists, they had always problem to call themselves feminists. Maybe they were not feminists. And so this is something completely missing in our sort of, even in our theory. There are there are some curators who deal with the problem, but maybe in a way more historically. But a strong feministic position is really missing, and it's I think it's happening just now that that we are sort of catching up with this. So it was really interesting to have these. Three girls here, there in Prague. And also one of them is coming for a residency to Prague in February. And we will produce yet another concert, but in London, because she has a really good club in London where they play. She has a bar and club, and so she invited two of the Czech groups. One is called Strzeszowicka Krama, and the other one is actually Václav Gyrsa from Strzeszowicka Krama, was also showing here in the Czech Center in March, right? And
So we are going to present to Czech alternative music art groups at her space in London next year. Thank you. this was a show of Estonian artist Chris Lemsalu. Sort of hurry, so I just went to show the space very quick because Ferdinand Bauman Gallery, it's a non-profit project space run by artists or art organizers. It's sort of considering. It's a very beautiful kind of like a windows or vitrine or showcases in one of the passages in the center of Prague. And so they, I think they, I didn't actually know how long they ran their program, but it's kind of interesting that in Prague there's some support from the Ministry of Culture and the City of Prague that organizations and associations are receiving every year for the year round program. So there's quite a lot of exhibition spaces and like non-profit galleries and they're like alternative spaces for culture. And so we're getting too many pictures. That's another window of the gallery. This last one.
The gallery also runs a festival of performance, which happens, I believe, every year. But it's really interesting space, like really site specific. So.
Yeah. Sorry, I'm not familiar with the computer, it's a little hard for me.
So then we invited the group, Irgun. I'm sure you all know them quite well. And I'm sorry. And we invited them for two lectures and one workshop at our school, where they decided to use the idea of their exhibition back to USA, and they reenact this exhibition. I'm not sure in the 80s sometimes, but I'm not sure which year it was. And they decided that they will do the same thing with the students, that we will choose one exhibition, Czech exhibition, and then they will reenact the exhibition. But then they decided, on the spot, they decided that they will reenact some pieces from the catalog East of Map. So, sort of to go more deeper into their project of this really important long-term project, when they basically created the art map of Eastern art. And we had like a big discussion about how the map is still contemporary today, and if there is a criticism of this position, because it's in a way like a really strong strong construction of how the history of East art looks like. So, but from our perspective, we think it was really, really important, this project, for the whole Eastern, so-called Eastern Bloc. And I think they were really great, because students really enjoyed the because they also teach, they also teach in Ljubljana, so they know how to do it.
This was a long-term project that we helped to organize to the artist Eva Koťátka. We previously also had a performance from the last year. So Eva, she's interested with the Artwood artists and art and also artists produced by the psychiatric patients. And she worked at the psychiatric hospital in Prague from April to September this year. And she created and produced a big exhibition there and a series of several performances and a big theater performance that sort of ended the whole piece. So just to...
It was also quite interesting because it was based on some like artist from the Brinthorn collection. So she would like analyze this, but also she would go into the archives of the of this psychiatric hospital. So it was a really huge research, which sort of ended up also in like her PhD PhD work and. And also it was, it bring again the question like where is the position of Art Bridge today?
What is the reaction of the public on this kind of exhibition? Is there some kind of social impact? Like the discussion about the people in these institutions and the state position?
It was because it was such a huge project that took place this year of Eva, but it was very much there were like many reviews in the major newspapers, but from the art critics, and I don't really think it sort of dissolved into another.
But it was really interesting. It also brought the question of. How can you work with such an environment? How can you work in such an environment, not to sort of abuse the place, you know, and the people there. So, but I think Eva is really sensitive in this sort of topic, and she was really careful with this topic and. She's one of the artists who does not cross the border, you know, to humiliate anyone. So she worked with the patients as well. Some of them, of course, when they were willing to cooperate and it was really interesting because some of the performances took place in the garden. This is like a theater they have in the hospital, and it's a really, really nice, nice hall. And it looked really like really natural for that space. You know, when you were just like walking through the garden and meeting the patients, but also. The art people, you know, and we were all like walking around. It's a beautiful place, but you know, there's also very sad.
So Eva, she cooperates with the dancers too. So there were several performances in her exhibition that took place in one art space that is located in the psychiatric hospital.
She's living in Prague?
Yes,
she lives in Prague, yeah, but travels a lot. She won a Chalupecký Award. I forgot which year, but Chalupecký Award is a prize for Czech artists under the 35-year-old. And it always is quite vibrant moment and on the scene, you know, each year. So we discuss like all kinds of problems of the culture and the scene, the art scene each year. So it's actually a platform for discussions, etc. So she wanted really young back then. She was still a student of Vladimir Skripal and Jiří Kovanda. And that also sort of brought a huge discussion of the price should be for such a young artist, or you know, which, if it's for more like advanced artists, etc. So she was one of the first ones which were that young. Of course, Kateřina Šedá was also very young when she won the prize.
So these are performances that took place to left about that took place in the psychiatric hospital grounds every Sunday, and Eva was inspired and sort of like were reenacting depictions of our group artists and psychiatric patients. So you can see that, that the performances were very like subtle, and they were staged as an images for 1 hour.
Like a tableau vivant situation.
Show you the videos on the documentation of the performances.
just don't touch.
What means ne dotikati se?
Don't touch.
Uh-huh.
Now it looks like a circus a little bit when we play it this way, but it was always only a few few performances, like two or three. So it was more subtle.
Just
stop us any time because there's no point of choosing one thing or another thing. Just stop us.
So at the end of this project, we organized in this theater performance. It was all created by Eva Kutak, as well as the screenplay and the costumes and the stage and basically everything. And the theater piece is based on an existing drawing by psychiatric patient Jakob Moore. The drawing is from I think 1909, and Jakob Moore was a psychiatric patient in Heidelberg in a psychiatric hospital there, and he sort of like depicted his trial because he was he committed some crimes, and he sort of like drew the trial. So Eva sort of
he sort of blamed his doctor that he was operating him. So you can see the machine and the strings, how he is operated, and he believed that he is controlled by his doctor.
And so Eva, she decided to invite for this performance director of the Prinzhorn collection from Heidelberg. It's a very important collection of Eichelt art. And so he took part in the performance and gave his explanation on the drawing that's in the collection of the Prinzhorn. So
it was like a lecture inside the a theater performance.
And actually the director of the Prinzhorn collection invited Eva with this performance to happen next year in Heidelberg. She's very happy about because it was it's very important for her to the whole collection is very important to her, so it's a kind of great success that she can show this piece at the collection.
So then we thought we also thought that the art scene is really not enough connected with the other parts like of the cultural world. So we wanted to in a way to connect a little more with the music scene and people around music, and decided to invite Dieter Diedrichsen to Prague. We cooperated with Goethe Institute in Prague on this event. And we asked him to introduce his book Über Pop Music, which is not really about about pop music, but more about like a pop culture, and it's really like it's quite a let's say have a theoretical construction, but for us it was important that he follows not only a music, but also he writes about art, he writes about theater, and he knows how to connect, make all those fields, and he's a quite interesting figure. And also we to Goethe Institute invited a couple of years ago Anselm Franke, and they both worked together on the exhibition The Whole Earth. Maybe I'm not sure if you're familiar with, but it was on exhibition on the Californian counterculture, and there's a really interesting catalog which they published together with also other contributors, but it's a really good. There are really good texts about the counterculture of the 60s. And we also published we published one of the translation of one of his texts in the A2 magazine. So we also cooperate with magazines or with it's more like a newspaper. Bi-weekly newspaper which comments on art, music, politics, and it's quite a left-oriented text. Oh, and also we wanted to invite a German writer, because we feel that the connection with the like German theory is really it's not enough in the Czech Republic. It's usually the English context less the German one, so that was also important for us.
And so from last year the National Gallery in Prague has a new chief curator, there's like a long ongoing story with the National Gallery that is not that was not functioning since the 90s, and so there was the situation like was kind of like very bad, and also the contemporary artists, they refused when they were asked to participate in the exhibition. They sort of like refused their participation because they didn't agree with the programming of the former directors. And so from last year there's a new director, his name is Adam Budak, he's Polish, and he actually make a pretty good contemporary program, and decided to collaborate with the National Gallery on October this year. They run a series of exhibitions that is dedicated to the moving image, and we thought that it would be interesting to accompany the exhibition with several events, international events, and create kind of accompanying but as well very independent events like screenings, lectures, another forms of presentations that will sort of be dedicated to the moving image. So the first the series of the program that we developed is called Parallel Format, and this kind of program we cooperate with a lot of different cultural organizations with cinemas and film archives, with the Academy of Fine Arts where Edith teaches. At the very first we invited two French curators who are kind of like specialized on film, on article. We did a special, very luckily, also new to us program. It was called Life Writing, where they actually basically they created series of films.
Who are those French creators?
They are called People Is Missing. Paris-based creators. And they created a series of films that was shown in a club cinema in the center of Prague. And we invited artists, curators, people from different fields like writers and philosophers to sort of react on the presented films by written form. And
yeah, it was like quite difficult format. We tried to also experiment with the formats. We want to know what's going to happen because this was totally new. And some writers refused to participate, some academics refused to participate, but still quite a lot of people participated. And we want to publish a book out of this event. The theme of the screening was called For a Differential Government of Times, and the theme was more based on like a chronopolitics, which if I make it really short, sort of in when we think of the governmenting of the space, we quite well understand what means the colonization of the space, and it's an ongoing problem. But there is also the situation when the time gets in a way colonized, and so it deals with different times, different regime of times. And how important it is when the event takes place in a certain time, and if it took place probably in a different time, it would develop completely differently. So it is really a lot about like the heterogeneity of the and like just the positions of different times and timing and sort of problem. Problematized the problem of the situation of the today viewing the time as a in a way presentism. And also talks about the different modes of time and imagining the future and reimagining the past.
So the second event...
Maybe we can say that we cooperated with the Bonner Postcinema here, which is also a really important institution for films. And they also are connected with the National Film Archive. So this is something what we also wanted to cooperate with the archive. So maybe the next time some of the curators can actually work maybe with the archive itself.
Sorry. So the second event from this series was screening by French artist and filmmaker Eric Bourdieu.
Will you be so kind to take the microphone a little bit nearer to you?
Sorry.
Thank you.
We organized three screenings of three films by Eric Bourdieu. He's a French filmmaker and artist. He has an interesting position within the art world because he shows at the big film festivals, but he also shows in the contemporary art institutions. That's quite kind of interesting phenomenon. Currently, that
that the genres, that the disciplines are sort of overlapping, and it's very much artists are producing films and are producing theater performances, and so and the other screenings were followed by discussions with Eric with the others. In one of the discussions, also the Erwin, Slovenian art group Erwin, was involved. It was a nice situation when Erwin sort of created, or they were part of the Neue Slowenische Kunst, and they created an, a state. So it was a nice discussion because Eric Boller was playing a movie, Letters to Max, I'm sorry, and it was about the state of Abkhazia, which is, it is a state, but it doesn't have proper legal status. And the screening was also done in Brno, where actually at the same time there were some visitors and activists from Abkhazia, so they had this discussion about how to handle the, you know, very political situation in a film.
So this is an American artist, Lisa Raven, that was in Prague like 2 or 3 weeks ago. She was leading a workshop with the students of Academy of Fine Arts, and then she showed or presented her 2 pieces. One was a film from last year called Curtains. It's a stereoscopic like a video installation, but we showed it in a very beautiful old cinema in the city center in Prague. So it's
the cinema. The whole building of the cinema belonged to uncle of Václav Havel, and it's a really nice space, but it's really well equipped with really good technique. So it talked also a lot about the film itself, you know, where was it screened historically. There were like the one of the first like a sound movies they played in this theater, so it had this historicity of the media, of the cinema. And Lucy Raven talks quite a lot about how the cinema is produced today, and how the economics of the cinema works, and how the 3D, actually in this case, the 3D cinema works, and how it's produced in different countries, like from Bombay to Vancouver and whatever. So it's sort of it's created in like assembly lines, and it's an enormous process which takes enormous time and employs really precarious type of workers. So, and then it's just because of the 3D quality of the image, so it's just for the illusion, or the sake of the illusion. So the cinema itself talks also about it.
So this was an exhibition that we organized in the National Gallery on September. It's still on. It's an exhibition, a solo exhibition of a French artist based in Berlin, Renaud Gilles. So I think we are running out of time, so I'll just go quickly through the images. But,
so see that it's quite possible to work with institutions hierarchically quite high, like a National Gallery, because the hierarchy is not really introduced in the Prague art scene, because it's you know, after the revolution we in a way had to create our spaces ourselves, and institutions which were present did not go through the proper process of transforming itself. So right now the National Gallery sort of opened up itself, and I think in a way quite relies on the relationship with the art scene, and it's really nice that it's happening, because if you go today to the opening in the National Gallery, it's enormous, huge building, and it's full of people and young people, so it's really nice to see that, even though it's not really easy to run the institution. It takes a lot of patience, and there are a lot of barriers, you know. So maybe we can end with this, and if you have any questions, please ask.